mine and Ryan. So they are reviewing the season 3 of Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous. Sorry I'm a day late to this. I remember when season 2 came out, like, I'm pretty sure like exactly 4 months ago. I was day one on that, and I got a review like as soon as after I finished the season. I saw this day one. I saw the season day one, but I'm a day late to the review. So I really enjoyed season 2. I thought it was a lot better than the first season. So I'm very much looking forward to this third season. Because the trailers promoted the season as a lot closer. There were actually gonna be 10 episodes, not 8 episodes, because it'll be a bigger story. I was really excited for it, Posters looked good, teasers and the promotional stuff looked good. So I was excited. So at like 3 a.m. I woke up yesterday, watched an episode of The Bad Batch, then hopped on my Netflix on my phone, watched an episode of new season of Camp Cretaceous. And I'm really happy to say this is definitely my favorite season so far. I think this season has just gotten a lot better. This season is definitely the best one in my opinion. It still has some problems, but I think it definitely nails a lot of stuff to the season did not. So, the season definitely is the darkest one yet. The since 10 episodes, a lot more jump scares. The season goes for a lot of jump scares. Kids, very small young children will be very scared of this season. There's some episodes which like almost nothing but jump scares. So, the scenes, it's a very action heavy season, so the kids are like going through toy chases with velociraptors, there's like helicopter chases with T-Rexes, one time Morphodon, aerial chases. There's a lot of chase action getaway scenes in this season, so it's a very entertaining season. Again, it's 10 episodes, so it's the biggest story. The season is darker. I really want to talk about, I won't go into any really spoilers, but the promotional stuff did tease the new hybrid dinosaur, and season 2 teased it, and it's a cliffhanger. The hybrid, who the name of as the Scorpius Rex. That is the best part of the season. This season goes from the same as season 2, where they're just trying to get off the island, and they're trying to find parts to fix this yacht that they found, to just full on survival mode, and you could straight up die, people get hurt. There's an entire episode where one of the characters is having to run across the island to get this one antidote to save another one of the characters' lives. It is great. The music is really solid in this season. The way the Scorpius Rex moves and screams and roars and how it hunts dinosaurs and eats people, it is something out of Primal. It the way it moves. How it, it's only shown, during nighttime. This is one time. There's, one episode where it's shown during the daytime. So it's always shown during nighttime, crawling up trees. It's sneaking on you. I like how, there's the episode where one of the characters is trying to run to get an antidote on the other side of the island to save one of the campers' lives. Two of the other campers are trying to create this big-ass fire, disturbance. To distract the Scorpius Rex from coming after the campers and trying to save the other campers' lives and eat them. It is really fast-paced. And there's a big twist in the final 2 episodes of how the season, I'm not gonna say it, but it's pretty interesting. Pretty interesting, especially in the second class episode. And the early scene is very interesting how it, stuff and how it may tie in. The animation is much better this season. The very impressive dinosaur animation is still really good. There's a lot more dinosaur stuff in this season. Like I said, there's a ton of chases. Blue is in this season. She has a very significant role in one of the episodes. The season definitely has the best run of episodes in my opinion. I'd say episodes 4, 5, 6 and are pretty fantastic episodes in my opinion. Final 2 are really good as well. The narrative episode, the end of episode 4 kind of comes along and completely changes. narrative of the season. And then the final two episodes are kind of just like big WTF episodes and just like flip the entire season on its head. And then there's a whole new thing we have to do if we want to like save a lot of lives. And there's characters from the movies that come up in this season. It's very fast paced. So season 3, definitely my favorite season. Still awesome for us. One, I think the narrative of the season changes. It changes like 3 times. The first 4 episodes are trying to get off the island. The 5 through 8 is basically like full on survival mode. And 9 through 10 are kind of just like shifting the narrative again and pulling it on its head instead of just like trying to get this one thing so we could like save a lot of lives and it doesn't fall into the wrong hands. There's another cliffhanger this season. This season does end on another cliffhanger. It's not what you think it might be, but I definitely do think they might be dragging this show out a little too much, so I'd say season 4, if they do a season 4, they should probably end up with that. So yeah. And there are still like some hokey jokes here. I will say the writing in the season is improved. The characters feel like more characters. The characters feel like people. So you know, when they're scared, when they're supposed to be scared, they aren't like cracking jokes or anything, they're actually scared and stuff like that. But the season is funny, you know, it's not like super funny or anything, but you know, there are some chuckle moments. There's some chuckle worthy moments. And the animation still can be a bit dark at times. But other than that, we really enjoy season 3, you know? Yeah, I'm gonna give it a B+, my favorite season yet. If they do a season 4, this is probably end of there, in my opinion. Because this season ends on a cliffhanger that doesn't really, like, the first 2 seasons end on a very, like, it definitely tells you what the next season is going to be about. This one doesn't, it just kind of leaves you on, like, okay, this is the cliffhanger, but we have no idea what it actually is. So, yeah. Still come on, and I'll see you all next time.